अरे यार स्टार्ट का चक्कर मत आ गई, कहाँ से मिलेगा? पास कर
पास कर दिया मैंने।
दिया? हाँ उसको पास कर दूंगा, पास मत करोगे? बोले
बोले
Hello, good evening everyone, and welcome to today's webinar. Today we are going to discuss about the significance of reading NCERTs and why is it important for us to go for NCERTs for the preparation of UPSC. A brief introduction about me. My name is Sherry A Singh.
ठीक आ रहा है, but पता क्या हो रहा है? आप ना एक साइड
start in another 2-3. 58.
Good evening, everyone. I hope we all can see me very clearly. All of us. So we are actually trying that more students can join us due to certain places where internet is not working due to the volatile conditions which are going on in the country. We are expecting more students to join us. How many of us can clearly listen to my voice? How many can listen to my voice? And guys, you can easily chat with me as well. You can send your queries and I'll be answering. So today's webinar is all about how to read NCERTs, why to read NCERTs, and do we need to make notes of them? And if we have to make notes, then how and from which classes or from which standards should I be reading my NCERTs? So any questions that we are having, guys, there is a availability of option where you can go and you can have a direct chat with me. So am I crystal clear? Guys, we have to say yes. We have to make the session interactive. We have to respond, actually, because the more you will interact, the more queries I'll come to know, and I'll also be very much clear about how we can make it better, how we can make our sessions more interactive. And there will be certain things for which you can ask me to make some video or we can have a webinar according to that. Mains result is not out yet, but the students, those who are preparing for next year prelims, keep on doing that. So today's webinar is all about, good evening everybody and those who have just joined us now, a brief introduction about me. My name is Sherry A Singh and currently I'm working as senior editor in Pearson. I also have a long story of UPSC preparation. I was an IS aspirant and in total I have written mains 4 times and 2 times I had been to interview. So what do you think, what propelled you today and what idea was there that you decided to become an IS officer? What do you think, what was your vision or what is your version of becoming an IS officer? This is something which I want to know. Can I know this? So I think I'm not able to see certain questions you students are asking. Any questions if you have, queries? Okay, I tell you how, I ask you one question, that what is your way of preparing NCERTs, those who have started? Before we start, Aryan Malik, you are saying read thoroughly. That's great. I hope I am visible to all. Okay, now am I, Aryan? Good. Okay. Reading them thoroughly, that's correct. But how to read them? That's what we are going to see. Okay. Very good, Aryan. That's great that you can see to me clearly. Now, before I proceed further, the slides are not moving. We have to see that. Okay. Now, before we proceed, whenever we start, whenever we think of becoming an IS officer, whenever we try to be an IS, we just think of the external factors. Maybe we want to join civil services. Why? Because somebody known you have seen, or you must be very clear about that an IS officer has power. I think this would be a very, very relevant reason that you are trying to become an IS, because you think that an IS officer has power. Main headings, important things in them, very good. Making important notes, very right, Aryan. Very, very good. So you are making notes of them, but the idea is how to make exact notes of it. So today I just forgot to bring my own NCERTs, that how I used to make my notes, but my next webinar is going to happen on 17th of January. On that day, I will show you my NCERT, that how the notes are to be made. I'm really very sorry, today I just skipped from my mind to get that NCERT book with which I used to make notes. So today, but we'll get something. Kuch toh hum leke jayenge is webinar se, because we'll have a clear-cut understanding why and how to make notes of NCERTs. And if yes, you are making notes, then why? Now, basic question is it really very important to read NCERTs? What is your take on it? What do you think? Do you think that reading NCERTs is important? Okay, so if yes, we are going to have a discussion about it. If yes, then why? Even if no, then why? From which classes the NCERTs shall be covered? So NCERT should not be a burdensome process for you. So unfortunately, students are buying some small supplementary books in order to read NCERTs. NCERT book is this much thin. It's already of a very small size. And you're again buying another book to supplement this book. That means there is a big flaw in your preparation. Today, we are going to understand the complete dynamism of NCERTs through this webinar. Aryan, you're very active. What about others? Okay, good. What about others, those who have joined the webinar? So please be interactive. Keep on asking questions. I'm there. If I won't be able to answer them now, then towards the end of the webinar, we are going to have a discussion of it. The next question is, should be notes made from these books? Note making process is an ongoing journey for all IAS aspirants. So any aspirant who decides to become an IAS officer and who takes a vow, a pledge that, yes, I want to become an IAS, what do you do first? You ask people around. And sometimes you ask somebody who is your senior, can be your father, it can be your mama ji, chacha ji, taya ji, anybody. And when you go to those people and you ask them, see, I have decided to become an IAS, they'll ask you to make notes. They'll ask you to read newspaper. Yes. But the thing is, now the trick is the way they used to prepare, this time we are not going to follow the same thing how they prepared. The complete pattern of preparation for civil services has undergone a change after 2013. Why? Because the syllabus of mains has been changed from two optionals, one optional, and four GS papers. So that means we cannot go with the same style of preparation. I hope things are getting clear to us. If things are not same, if syllabus is not same, if the questions being asked by UPSC are different, are unique, are dynamic, notes making process should also be different. Am I bringing you some clarity, guys? Because you are sitting from 4 to 5. It is evening, it's Friday evening. So salute to your complete confidence and your determination to join this webinar today. This shows that you are already, you have achieved 50% of success. That your mind is oriented towards success. You want to be an achiever. Correct? Good. So am I bringing or am I able to convey? Say yes or no. Good, good, good. Thank you so much. So shall I proceed? Okay, so we are getting some questions as well. Fine. All are saying yes. If there is no query, that means things are going great. So how many times should we be revising them? You know, you would have come across, if you would have been into 1 year of preparation, at least you have spent 1 year in your preparation and you would have been going to coaching classes, you would have gone to some other institutes, and when you get out of the institute, you are fully loaded with what the faculty has taught, the study material of your institute, and plus the NCERTs. Now you keep on juggling between, should I go for NCERTs first? Should I read this? Should I read that? Should I read this? Well, you are completely cluttered. You are done. This was my condition also when I was preparing. But now there is another culture, which is the culture of YouTube videos, which was not there. It was not so significant. It was there of watching videos on YouTube for UPSC preparation. We never used to consider that, okay, I don't understand this topic, I'll directly go to YouTube. If we were not able to understand one topic, we used to read it from various other sources. Now we have YouTube. But even then, students claim to have done the revision of NCERTs from like 6 times, 7, 10, 20, 30, 40. Come on, are you making a Guinness of World Book record? Are you making some Limca book of records? Ke bhai, maine to NCERT 100 baar padha hai. Why? Kyun padha hai aapne 100 baar? The concept of winds coming from one direction or concept of monsoon is never going to change. If you have understood it once, it's done. Once done should be done forever. Again and again, you are repeating the same things. You are ruminating. You are again and again involving into the same stuff. What you are doing, you are simply wasting your time. Now, the questions you can ask is that, ma'am, isn't it NCERT very important? Yes, it is important. But how much is it significant that you are reading same stuff again and again? To whom are you trying to prove? To yourself or to somebody else? Or to the friend who has done NCERT 6 times? क्यों भाई तुम्हें तीन बार में समझ नहीं आया तुम्हें सारी एनसीईआरटी समझ नहीं आई माय पॉइंट ओवर हियर टुडे माय वेबिनार एंड व्हेनेवर यू अटेंड माय वेबिनार्स माय पॉइंट इज नॉट ओनली टू ब्लैबर द इंफॉर्मेशन एनीबॉडी कैन गिव यू द इंफॉर्मेशन दिस एनसीईआरटी दिस डिस्कशन एनीबॉडी कैन डू आई वांट यू टू बी साइकोलॉजिकली स्ट्रांग योर ओन स्ट्रेटजी इज वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट Now, there is difference between strategy and a plan. At the very first level or at the very first webinar of mine I discussed about, you should have your own strategy. You should know what you want to do, how you have to do. For certain people, studying 6 hours a day is a sufficient process, but for others, it can be 8. For me, geography was not so easy when I started my preparation, but for a friend of mine, it was very easy. But for her, history was a difficult task. For me, it was a cakewalk. Everything is different for everyone. Right? Now, don't think that somebody who is successful, somebody who is an IAS officer now and or is in the position to tell you certain things and you get motivated is fine. But you are following their footsteps, what they are doing. Somebody tells you that you have to study whole night and in the morning time you sleep, but you are not able to do that because this is not your body. So create your own strategy. Self-awareness is important. Why do you want to become an IAS number one? Secondly, you have to be always motivated. It is not that you'll be always very happy. Always you'll be like, okay, I'll do it. There will be times when you would feel like, why am I doing it? I'm losing my patience. But again, you have to, you know, somehow get back to the process. Then third, it is you who's going to make the difference. Neither me nor anybody else. Right? So psychologically, brainically, and in your mind, you should be there. Strategy will be fixed. Your plans will keep on changing. Your strategy will remain always fixed. That's why I said in the first webinar of mine, create a very careful strategy. Plans you can keep on changing. For example, now New Year is coming. You may have to visit your family. You may have to go out with friends. Go out. But try to plan accordingly so that you do not miss out on your studies. Right? Are we getting new things? We should get new things always. Attending same thing, same type of stuff is not going to help you at all. Then is it really worthy to study NCERTs again and again before every attempt? Is it significant that I have lost this attempt? Next attempt again, I am, you know, trying to read them again from prelims, again and economy again. Why would you do that? Do you think it is important? Now, what is your take on it? I'll give you 30 seconds to think about it. What do you think? Is it worthy to read NCERTs again and again? The fuss about NCERTs, is it real or is it a myth? What do you think? And how many of you are the first timers? Let's be interactive. Okay, one question. Venkatesh, Dhananjay, Dinesh, Sunil. So guys, I think we can expect all of us. More are there. Harsha, you are saying it's the first time. So have you prepared it earlier or this is the first time that you are going to come? All of us, please, guys. I request, this is my humble request for you, Manpreet. More are joining. Preparing on process. Okay, preparing on process. I'm sorry, Harsha, I'm not able to get you what you're saying, preparing on process. So you are on process that you are saying, that you are on the way of preparation. So guys, in my next webinar today, I'm again very apologetic. Today, somehow I skipped my NCERT to bring, where I wanted to show you that how I made notes and what was my strategy. So for all those who are new, I am working as senior editor in Pearson now. I was also an IS aspirant. Two times I had been to interview, and in total I have written mains 4 times. So in total I had 6 attempts, so I have exhausted them. Correct? Now I'm there to help you out. Any queries or doubts that we have? Why NCERTs are significant? Why do we need to go for them? Is an important part. One question that we have received. No issues, Arsha, that we are working on it. That's why today we have decided to, you know, complete your NCERT books. How will you read it and how would you understand these things? That's what. Now we are, I'm sorry, there must be some glitch because of which you were not able to see me. Can you see me now? Dinesh, step by step, we are going to come to that point that class 6 standard, should we be reading, should we be going for 12 standard, or should we be leaving all NCERTs altogether? Can we be so gutsy to leave NCERTs altogether? I don't think so, we will be. I want you to have an understanding that NCERTs are basically basic books. I think, guys, I'll take a 10-second pause because there is some technical glitch which is coming up because of some internet fluctuation. So just give me 10 seconds. We want to get back to you, right? Because of some fluctuation which is going on, hang on there. Just give us 10 seconds. Am I audible to all of us now? Okay, now the first thing is that why we are going to go for NCERTs, why should we be going for it is, it begins journey towards your goal. Now somebody can be from medical background, somebody can be from humanities background, somebody can be from any other background. But when we start with UPSC preparation, the first thing that comes to our mind, or the first thing that we see, is that are we able to understand things? And NCERT, it gives you the basic stepping stone. This was how the wind was, though we have read it in our school times, that this is revolution, this is rotation. And based on all those simple concepts, the advanced study comes. So this means that one thing is very clear, we cannot escape from reading NCERTs. And also, if I am somebody who is from, I am a doctor, if I am a doctor, then I may have forgotten some part of humanities, of some part of social science, that is polity part. I may have completely forgotten the making of the constitution. Now, NCERT tells me that who are, were the members of the drafting committee. Later on, you can move on to the higher or the advanced version of the books. But for the while, at the beginning, today, it gives you an insight that, okay, fine, okay, this was polity. Somehow you are able to establish the link. You see, if you try to analyze the syllabus of UPSC, everything is being asked. History, polity, geography, art and culture, everywhere the questions are coming to you. But the questions are not coming in a simplistic manner as they used to come earlier. They are current oriented. They are also sometimes very, very conceptual. That means one thing is clear, concepts have to be clear. Correct? This has to be clear. What is this movement of air known as? And what is this movement of air known as? These things should be clear. What is advection? What is convection? And everything must be clear to you. Now, these simple terms, small terms, why westerlies are known as westerlies? So these small things you will learn from the basic books. Nobody can come and tell you. Then orient your process towards preparation. There is an orientation of yours. Automatically you get through the orientation. And I suggest you one thing, all of those who have not started going for the preparation or for the coaching institutes, read your NCERTs at the first hand and then you proceed further. Don't start jumping to watching videos, because I know we love to watch videos these days. Even I watch. YouTube is our favorite. And when while you are reading something, you are stuck somewhere, you will quickly do what? You will go and watch a video. What you will do when you will watch a video, you will not like it. There will be more suggested videos, more recommended videos will come into your feed. Then you will keep on watching them, watching them, watching them. If you are on Facebook, you will find plenty of people talking about it. What is going to happen? Drainage of energy. You lose your potential to do something. More information we are getting, more we are getting involved amongst the people, the more we are losing out on the fronts. Any questions if we have till now? So preparation, I tell you, becoming an IAS officer is not difficult, but it is tricky. Why tricky? Because we have to always, always stay grounded. Grounded per se, how you will say, you have to stick to your own strategy. You can listen to the other people. You can always imbibe good things. Achha, you ask questions. Kya pada bhai? Maine to bhai polity khatam kar li hai. And you are reading history. You will leave history and you will go to polity. Kaun si kitab achhi hai history ke liye? You will buy one book from, and you will ask the bookseller, should I buy this book? Hanji sahab ji, bahut bikti hai. This book is something which is sold like hotcakes. You go and buy this. Once you brought it to your room or to your space, you have discussion with your friend of yours. He or she says, this book is blunder, bullshit. Don't read it. Kuch nahi aata hai. UPSC says, is kitab se koi sawal hi nahi aaya. Arey bhai, tumhe kaise pata hai? Koi sawal nahi aaya. People will tell you like 100% confidence. There is no question from this book ever. This book is futile. Bekaar hai. Phenk do. Arey bhai, tumhe itna pata hota tha, tum IAS ban jaate. So this is something which is very crucial. That's why I say stick to your own preparation, your own strategy. Be very careful while choosing the things and while leaving the stuff. You should know what you have to learn and what you have to let it go. Ignore the people, ignore the negative people around you and in your life. Some question is there in front of us. Let me see. Okay, so the question is, let me see the question. Optional subject for Monica, very good question. Optional subjects, again, if you are a beginner at the basic level, I'm saying it is give you a basis. This is a foundation. For example, before beginning for UPSC preparation, you're coming randomly from one background. When you read NCERTs, it gives you one basic foundation. Now you have realized. And you also, if you have attended my previous webinars, I don't know have you attended or not, I've also talked about how to choose optional. Now, go and see the previous year question papers. You will come to know your own bent of mind. Are you okay for understanding the philosophies? Are you okay to go for political science? Now your bent of mind is more like commerce student. You are a CA and you should go there and excel. But you have opted for PubEd because everybody is opting PubEd. And you say that there is everybody who is going for a PubEd becomes an IS in first attempt, second attempt, third. Okay, fine. But your bent of mind is very much different. And you will feel bored while you are going for philosophies, international relations philosophy. You will feel kya hai. You won't be able to express yourself. Yes, coming down to your question, Monica, it definitely helps you to orient your own understanding. It's like, again, you are rethinking. Again, you are choosing a profession. Choosing an optional is as good as choosing a profession. You know, when we were in 10th standard, we chose some streams. Some of us, we joined commerce. Some went for humanities, some medical, some non-medical. We chose those things because based on the marks that we got in the 10th standard. Or today also things are like that, only economy we choose. Similarly, when you again start your preparation for UPSC, again you have to think, what is your bent of mind? What is your aptitude? That is why GS paper 4 means, they say ethics, integrity and aptitude, not attitude. Attitude is different from aptitude. Aptitude means, attitude is, ye ghatiya hai, ye achha hai, this is ugly, this is beautiful, this is awesome, this is something which is, I'm not gonna do that. This is attitude. Aptitude is, okay, this is ugly, this is something which I don't want, this is something which I don't like, but I should know how to make it likable. This is aptitude. This is something which is very pretty. This is something which is very likable. How I can share it with other people? Now, this is the difference between attitude and aptitude. That is why Union Public Service Commission in 2013, they changed the syllabus because when you are going to become an IAS officer, when you decide to be on the chair of responsibility along with power, money, prestige, responsibility is going to come to your face. You will see in your district that how things are getting managed and how you can bring change in the lives of not just one or two people, in the lives of many. Zindagiyan lag jati hai logon ko apni zindagi badalne mein. Kai baar mauka hi nahi milta. People don't get the opportunity to change their own lives. And you will be so lucky to bring, to have the potential and the capability to bring the change in the lives of many. Correct? So it was a small question, optional? Yes, it gives. We can have another webinar about how to choose optional, and you can also share direct conversation with me on my email ID, which I'll be sharing you towards the end. You can definitely have ideas sharing with me, and you can contact me also, I don't mind. One more question that we have come up. You have chosen economics as an optional. Can you, Dhananjay, I can suggest you for GS paper. We have also come up with, Monica, you are always very welcome. And towards the end of webinar, as I've already said, I'll be sharing my email ID with you. And if students also want to interact later on, I can also, on my email ID, I can also share my phone number with you so that you can always interact with me. Okay, so Dhananjay, you are saying that you have chosen economics as an optional. Can you please suggest some specific book, if any? Optional cannot be done only from one or two books, right? But I can tell you one book for GS economy. That is, we have just come up with one book. I can share the details of that. That book is going to cover everything from basic to advanced. That is the one book which I have with me right away. Towards the end of the webinar, I can show you. So that book is going to, just now we have launched, that book is going to cover every nitty gritty. I suggest you read that book before going to your optional, because optional is going to be very vast. But when you have the basics clear and advanced study clear, which is relatively for GS students, it will be easy for you to navigate, to meander into your economy paper. Am I okay, Dhananjay? Specific book, you cannot say for one for it's okay for optional. I don't think that it will be right on my part to do that. Just beforehand, if we are going to read NCERTs, then which classes we have to cover? very beginning, I'm new. I am somebody who has today taken a pledge. Aaj hi ghar walon ko bola bhi IAS banna hai. For me, it is significant to go through all the NCERTs from 6th to 12th standard. All I would refer to geography, history, polity, primarily. Geography, history, polity, you have to go through from 6th to 12th standard. That will be your first reading. In your second reading, that will be your bird's eye view. Don't get stuck if you're not able to understand anything. Don't get stuck over there. Don't get stuck anywhere in your life. Move. Always move ahead. If you're not able to understand this point, leave it. Don't keep on cribbing about it. Don't keep on, you know, wasting your energy over here. Move. Move ahead. Move further. Once you will move, what will happen? You will cover other stuff. Now, when you will move on to the second reading, you will come to write down with some pencil, pen, whatever. I don't have that sort of feeling. Don't write with pen on your books. I used to write with pen. So I'm sorry. I was not somebody who used to write with pencils, sharpening them. I used to write with everything with my pen. Mention there, because I want things to be clear that I was not able to understand. When you are going to go for second reading, you will understand the significance where you were lacking behind, right? You can make notes of it. So second reading will be more a sincere reading than the first one. Then there will be third one will be more like a revision of what you have done so far. After doing the third part, right, then you have come to know that still I'm not able to understand the mechanism of monsoon. Still I'm not able to understand other stuff of Indian polity. This means that I'm not able to remember the facts. This means I'm not able to factually imbibe the things in my mind, right? So I have to learn more. I have to mug up certain facts, or I have to revisit the concepts. Then it is going to be very easy for you. After third or fourth reading, there is no need to read all the NCERTs from 6th to 12th. Just take the look of 9th, 10th and 11th, or maybe 12th. Also, after going through all NCERTs, you have to browse. You have to see. I know none of you are going to do this. I am very much sure that none of you are going to follow it. But if a single person amongst you today, this moment, at this given point of time, just try to accept and trust what I am saying, I'll be responsible for that person's success. Because what I am saying, I'm not speaking from the point of view as somebody who is working as senior editor in Pearson. I have undergone the trauma of preparation. See my word, trauma of preparation. Because I have seen why I have wasted my time. Where you people are, I was also there. I also used to get stuck. I used to buy more and more books. If you would have seen my room at that given point of time, apart from books, you could not find anything else. So your room has to be clutter-free. And after going from 6 to 12, three readings, always, please, please, if anybody who is going to believe me, trust me today, trust on that part, go through your previous year question papers. Because previous year question papers gives you an insight that how you can prepare well, how you can answer more questions, where are you lagging behind, how much work you have to do. Okay, so this is how you have to prepare yourself. This is how the NCERT's reading and studying will be more beneficial. Not just reading, not just making notes. It is all about practicing. Do you remember when we used to be in our schools? We used to practice so many questions. Monthly test, weekly test, first term, second term, third term, pre-boards, everything used to happen. We used to read and we used to test. But when we are in UPSC preparation, we are reading. We more feel we don't know. And whatever we know, we tend to lose in the feeling of that I'm not knowing anything. We always feel kuch aata hi nahi hai. This feeling is always persistent in our mind. I hope I'm making some sense to all of us. And my question is clear or not? Shall I move ahead or something? Ma'am, can you share the strategy of making notes with a topic as an example? Yes, I can. And again, I'm saying that I have just, I'm not brought to my art and culture book of NCERT. I'm going to talk about how to make notes of. Monica, I was very close. This means that Monica is on the orientation process of knowing how things are, how NCERT is going to be done. Should notes be made from these books? If yes, then how? If no, then why? What do you think that, what is the notes making process? Why do we make notes? Okay, let me ask you a question. Why do we make notes? What are notes? It's a question for you. You can take 5 minutes, 10 minutes. I won't proceed unless you won't answer this question. What is notes? Why do we make notes? And what is the basic thing? I don't think it's a very difficult question to revise easily. Okay. So notes are what basically? Are they to help you or they to increase your burden? मुझे ये book भी पढ़नी है, इसके बाद मुझे ये notes भी देखने हैं. I have to read my book as well and then I have to see my this notes as well. I have to read. Is it to increase your burden or is it to decrease your burden? This is my question. Can we say yes or no at least because we are very lazy. I know it's cold. In Delhi, it's cold. I don't know from which places are we coming on. Aryan, you have left. So we are not able to see. I think there is some technical glitch. Some students, they are suffering from. Okay. Very right, Monica, that we make notes to revise. This means that the purpose of notes is to help us, to assist us, to make our life easy, not difficult or boring or monotonous. That means some notes I call them, which I was supposed to show you today, preferably make then and there notes. For example, this is a book. Let's say this is a book in front of you. While reading this stuff, you are stuck somewhere. You have to make some small notes over here only on a plain paper. Just attach it over there, then and there. Small part will be a section of your notes making process. Highlight it and keep it there with you forever. So whenever you are going to read this book, whenever you will read the book, you will clearly see, okay, now this was something which I was not able to understand. I can see from here. Even if you want to open the book, whenever you will open the book, you will see, okay, these are the notes that I have made. Staple your books. And if you think that it is making my book dirty, no, it is not making your book dirty. Rather, it shows that you have worked on your book. So this book, one book of yours will become a workbook where you have done work as well. Okay, now the other approach is that this is something, this is a book in front of you. And it is true for every book that you read. Now, this is a book you have read and then you take another notebook or copy or something where you have started making notes. Now you have this thing to read, you have this thing to read, and then you have to synchronize. And in case you're this, let's say if this is your book, it is gone somewhere, you have to see the pictures as well, you have to see, you cannot 100% copy whatever has been mentioned in the book. That means you cannot copy the essence of the book. Only notes will not help you, but done through the reading with the book, they are going to help you a lot. And make notes for those topics which are complex and confusing for you. So again, your notes are clear cut. You know where are they kept. You know my art and culture. This is my book. I have to go through this. It's done. Once done, done forever. Right? In case you are making on separate notebooks, then you will search for that book and then you will read, you will open the book and then you are like more or less you are wasting your time. Each and every minute is important for us. Another important point is always make notes for those things which are new for you, complex, confusing, critical, or something which is there in current affairs. For example, Citizenship Amendment Act is very much into news. Though you have not studied it anywhere from any book or you're watching YouTube videos for that, you are watching some daily analysis, I will suggest you. The previous webinar was regarding how to read newspaper, right? So I will suggest you to have your own notebook regarding all these current events which are happening. So you can make small notes from there. Ayodhya verdict, you can make a note of it. And other things what are going on, you should be very clear. Notes should not be very long. They should be very small. They should be crisp. They should be to the point so that once you get back to them for a reading, maybe always keep Sunday for revision. Monday, to Friday, do all your learning part, and Saturday, Sunday, keep for revision. Saturday, you can keep for all those things which you have left, which you were not able to complete on your weekdays, and Sunday, you can keep for revising the stuff, what you have done till Monday to Friday. In this manner, the preparation will be step by step, and you will be also revising. The revision part will never be difficult for you if you follow this sort of plan. You can change your plan accordingly, but I think it is the most suitable one. Correct? So notes are of two types. One is related to NCERTs or other books, which I would prefer there and there. Another notes making process, which should be also very continuous, is related to your current events. I understand we have books available, booklets available. Every institute is coming up with all the books. I have also purchased them. You can purchase them, you can read them, understand them. They'll help you in cementing what you have done. Never use 4, 5, 6 colored pens. You don't make your own mission Indradhanush that you have to use so many colors to make it beautiful. The notes should be crisp, clean, clear, assorted, and you should know if I'm talking about environment, which book I need to carry. Book would refer to which notebook I have to take up. It is not that you are so much confused, you don't know where the environment questions are, you don't know where the other notes are. Correct? Please, any doubts if we have till now? I started making notes when I was like, I was writing all the time. It was my very, you know, early years of preparation. My first time when I started preparing for civil services, I also asked somebody, though my family is a family of bureaucrats, but still I asked some friend of mine and she said me, you start making notes. You won't believe I used to only make notes. My whole time, energy, anything, everything used to go in making notes. I was never able to revise it. And the first time when I was out of the prelims, it was just because I was not revising my stuff clearly. Then gradually I developed my own strategy. Then I realized that it is significant for me to read all the newspapers on everyday basis. And also I have to make notes, or I never made notes of everything, right? So we have one question coming up. Let me see this question. Question was there, suddenly it's not visible. Can you retype the question again? So this is how I lost my 1 year. That then came the main examination. People used to say, okay, now you only have to keep on, you know, going to the test series. But apart from joining test series and writing over there, it is important that you also write something on your own. Choose your 10 years previous year questions, pick one question randomly and start writing it. It is the most difficult task to do. To stay disciplined, to be oriented, it is the most difficult thing to do. Even today, if I have to do something, sometimes I'm not so disciplined. So discipline is the key to success. Correct? This was my experience when I was preparing. More questions can I expect? You guys are great audience. I think you guys are on the right track. More questions can we expect? I'm waiting, guys. I'm like you only. Yes, 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 yes. Questions are coming. I'm not able to see the questions, guys. I'm not able to see the questions. Okay, Harsha, you are studying in college and you are also having your own timetable. Okay. Harsha, if you are preparing for your college, now is your college, which year you are in? This depends that are you in first year, are you in last year, or you are having quite a hectic schedule, you are always busy. Now, if you are always busy, for example, if you are always occupied in your college stuff, in your timetable, in your curriculum of college, that has to be a priority for the while. You have to spare some 2 hours, at least minimum 2 hours to start with UPSC preparation. I'm not saying you to go for a complete thing, but at least minimum 2 hours. I think throughout week at the first level, throughout week, can you spare some 2 hours for your preparation? If you can do that, that is really going to help you. Am I clear to all of us? I think some slides are moving. It's not end actually, guys. There's some glitch. There are some network issues which will be happening. Can you see the questions? I'm not able to see. So Harsha, are you satisfied that 2 hours can you spare for your preparation? Somebody has raised their hand. Okay. Now, 2 hours, start with one subject which you like. But don't leave that subject in between and keep on hopping from one to the another. One, two, three, four. One subject. And I'm going to give you my email ID, and then we can have one-to-one discussion. You can call me at any given point of time later on, and I can help you with the preparation as well. Right? So this one-to-one discussion that we can have. So by that time, you will end your graduation. You will be at least done with your NCERTs and your previous year's question paper. This means that you have done 80% of your work. Electricity is out, guys, you know, because of the things which are going on in our country. I hope I'm still, you can clearly see me. Okay, now the other thing is how many times these all NCERTs are to be covered. I think I have already clarified this answer. Still, if somebody is not clear, happy, or somebody wants to know something more, I am leaving this question open-ended. We can have discussion about it. How many times these all NCERTs are to be covered? Interaction, when you are sitting for a webinar, who is stopping you? Who is trying to say that don't speak? Who is trying to say that don't talk? Write your answer, write your question, type your question, because raising hand does not show us your question. Type what you have to say. More questions? Okay, we have one. Yes. Keep on revising your NCERTs once you study in parallel. Very true. But you should have done NCERTs at least for once. First part of is reading NCERTs. Second is knowing NCERTs. When you come to know what you know, what you don't know. And the final part will be the revision of NCERTs. These three things will be done automatically on a loop without putting your effort, without even you being realizing it. Effortlessly, if you do the preparation, things will be very easy for you. You know, it is not difficult examination. We make it difficult by thinking a lot. Because we are being programmed like that. Monica, we have already discussed about it. It is possible to cover syllabus within 5 to 6 months. My first webinar, you will be astonished to know, was about this only. Can we get prepared for civil services just within 1 year? So I had bifurcated that how you have to cover first 6 months and then the later half of the 6 months, and then how within 1 year you can completely be done with your UPSC preparation. So first 6 months, first 2 months at least, give it to your optional. Just think of optional. And even when you have decided optional, do not leave your newspaper behind. Don't think that I'll do newspaper, pehle main optional khatam kar lu, then I will read newspaper. Newspaper, current information is like flowing, fast flowing river. It's going, going, going. You have to catch the momentum. You have to catch the current of that flowing river. You cannot sit idle ke koi baat nahi, wo kabhi chalenge, ho jayega, kabhi padh lenge. Are bhai, kaise hoga? You'll be bored. Read newspaper every day. How to read? I have already covered it, but I'll cover it in my next webinar as well, because we have new students. I'll give you 5-10 minutes small brief about how to read newspaper. I'll bring newspaper and you also carry your newspaper on 15th of January 2020. So on that day, that particular day, again at 4 to 5, 17th of January, I'm sorry, again, we'll understand how to read the newspaper, right? Yes, we can cover once we have decided optional, we are done with its coaching part, or we are done with it completing on our own, then move on to another. Your GS paper, but newspaper, that is current affairs, should not be left at any cost. Monica, I think that I am able to answer your question. Because we think a lot. That's what I was saying, that we tend to think a lot. We keep on thinking, we keep on asking, and we ask people, what do you think mera ho jayega? And you ask them elderly also, maine itne ghante padha hai. Do you think that I'll be able to solve? You're welcome, Monica. Harsha, are you okay that reading, it's possible to go for NCERT revision? How many times these all NCERT to be covered? I have discussed it. 3 times. For Harsha, you have to go for only 2 hours per week, because Saturday, Sunday, I'm sparing you for the while, because you'll be having your own life, you'll be having your own curriculum to complete. Okay, yeah, we are back. Okay, so light is life. So we are back. Understand. Oh, you're welcome, Harsha. But I would love that if you start doing what I'm saying. Have your own strategy, create your own plan, but try to always trust the people, those who have undergone the same trauma of preparation and understanding. We have experienced whatever you are experiencing now. I have undergone the same thing. And you know, there is another experience which I, God forbids, I don't want you to experience. Once you are at the apex level of interview, and when you fall from interview, you are shattered. Again, you rise, again, you go for prelim. So I don't want this thing to happen to you. I just want that whosoever are preparing, just within their first attempt, they all should have a breakthrough and they become an IAS officer. Okay, so more question. Okay. This question is clarified. I'll proceed further. Is it really worthy reading NCERTs again and again? Again and again, you can read if you don't understand, if you're not able to comprehend, or maybe you are from a bit of your schooling, or your maybe your education was not the way other students are having. So it can be difficult for you to understand certain things which are easy for other people, right? Then you have to read them again and again. So it is not something which is set in stone that you have to do these things like that only. If you think that your basics are very, very, very dicey, they are super unclear, then you can give it a reading. You can give it a fourth reading and fifth reading as well. What I have said it earlier, it is in the very ideal situation that you are okay with the things and your schooling is okay, was up to the mark. You know the things, right? But if you are coming from a background, or if you're coming from which that background, which is not so smooth, your schools were not so comfortable, they did not make you comfortable with the basics, then we may have to read it again and again. But this again and again should not be a habitual, perpetual process. You have to stop it somewhere. You have to stop at least after fourth reading. You cannot read them again and again. Once you have understood, maybe after fourth reading, you realize that now I know the concepts, you have understood them. Don't keep them again and again. NCERT should not become a loop process. Another caution, don't buy other small booklets to understand NCERTs. Then you are doing a fatal job. I have to say this very blatantly. If you are reading those books to help you to read NCERTs, guys, please leave preparation for UPSC. You are not meant to become a civil servant. Becoming an IAS officer is a job of responsibility. Come on, you cannot complete your NCERTs. What sort of aptitude are you having? How will you control so much of pressure? How will you handle everything? You have to handle the politicians, you have to handle the people, you have to handle the masses, those who are angry, those who are sometimes, you have to handle an unexpected situation. So you should be always, you know, quirky, you should always be active in your mind, but you're not able to handle this NCERTs, then do you think that you have that aptitude, you have that sort of understanding to handle the situation? I'm not demotivating you, but I'm telling you the truth. I never demotivate. I never do that. I have never done it. But I have learned to tell the truth. Realities must be always clear to us. Right? So today we are done with the session. All the best and wish you all a very, very, very happy and glorious Happy New Year in advance. Any questions if we have, we have some time. Any questions, 2-3 minutes still we are having. Any questions if you have, please. Okay. Happy New Year. So guys, have a safe New Year. It's cold in Delhi. And if you meet people, if you want to do a better for society, try to control the volatile situation which is going on in our country. We all are one. We, the people of India, do hereby adopt that and give to ourselves this constitution. So we all are one. And I would suggest you to do something for yourself and do something for society. That's my message. My email ID to you is that I can type it over here. It's sherry.singh. Answer. Okay, thank you, Monica. It's a big compliment. You are, you know, making my day that this webinar was very helpful. So next webinar is on 17th of January. And on 17th of January, I'll be again back with you. And on 17th, I'll bring my NCERT. I'll bring my newspaper for you all. And then we can have a little bit more understanding about how to, you know, understand and meander through the information that we have got. Correct? Psychology is going to play a vital role. Your energy is going to play a very great role. I don't want you to foresee all those things. Okay, so Dinesh, you're saying you have 4-5 months for exam. Give some. You have to dedicate your time, divide your time, Dinesh, accordingly. For example, if you are full-fledgedly working for UPSC preparation only, you're not going anywhere, then create a timetable. For example, you start from 9 to 10:30, okay? Create one subject slot. Then from 11, I'll give you half an hour break so that you can move, you can think. And I'm not against going for breaks, but breaks should not be very long. I'm sorry. Then from 11 to again 1 or maybe 12:30. So these small, small slots you can make. Keep on revising geography, history, polity, side by side, keep on revising. Do not shift your timetable and sleep at a proper time. Wake up at a proper time. Sleeping with at least you have by 12 o'clock, you should be on bed. At least rise up at 6:30 or at 6. 7, 8, you have 2 hours or maybe 1 hour to dress up to do the breakfast. And once you are sitting for study. You should not keep on taking breaks. Now I should go for bathing. Now I have to go for the breakfast. Now don't do such stuff. And do not keep awakened throughout night. It is going to only spoil your preparation later on. You may get success in prelims, but in mains, you have to be agile. You have to be very active. You have to keep on writing. Just on the day of examination, at least you have to write 6 hours a day. That means your preparation of writing should be 12 hours per day before the paper. So we used to write 12 hours. We used to keep on writing. How will you do that? Only when you have some schedule, when you know how the things can be assorted. So current affairs should go hand in hand, right? Newspaper should be done on a daily basis, plus your subjects. Create your plan accordingly, a timetable. At least minimum, your timetable should include 8 hours of study every day. That has to be a ritual. Dinesh, I'm okay with this suggestion, I hope. More things will come up in my next webinar because we are running short of time as well. Right, Dinesh? My email ID goes as, it is to be sent to all. Sherry.Singh@ Sherry.Singh@Pearson.com is my email ID. So guys, have you received my email ID? If you have, please say yes. All of us, Monica, Harsha, and others are in. So guys, I hope no more queries, no more questions are left, or we are still having some questions. If we have, please, you're more than welcome. You didn't receive mail? Now have you received? Have you received, Harsha, now? I hope you must have received now. Okay, guys, wish you all a very, very happy new year. Be positive, stay healthy, and be an IAS officer this year. Catch you soon on 17th of January 2020 with new good luck, new aspirations, new hope, and we hope that we'll be very helpful. I'll be personally very helpful to see you becoming IAS officers with glorious success. All the best and happy new year. Bye-bye.